નમસ્તે. રામ નામનો મહિમા અપરંપાર છે. રામનું જીવન જ એક સંદેશ છે. રામના જીવનમાંથી આપને મર્યાદા, મિત્રતા, આદર્શ અને સરળતા શીખવા મળે છે. રામ આદિ છે, અનંત છે અને હનુમાનજીના સ્વામી પણ છે. રામનું નામ જ લેતા સમસ્ત દુઃખ અને પાપોનો નાશ થાય છે. તો પ્રસ્તુત છે સત ચિત્ત અને આનંદ સ્વરૂપ પ્રભુ શ્રી રામના ગુણગાન ગાતી આ સ્તુતિ. જય રઘુનંદન, જય સિયારામ. નમસ્તે.
જય રઘુનંદન, જય સિયા રામ.
જય રઘુનંદન, જય સિયા રામ.
ભજ મન પ્યારે જય સિયા રામ.
ભજ મન પ્યારે જય સિયા રામ.
જય રઘુનંદન, જય સિયા રામ.
જય રઘુનંદન, જય સિયા રામ.
આદિ રામ અનંત હૈ રામ.
આદિ રામ અનંત હૈ રામ.
સત ચેત ઔર અનંત હૈ રામ.
સત ચેત ઔર અનંત હૈ રામ.
જય રઘુનંદન, જય સિયા રામ.
જય સિયા રામ.
भज मन प्यारे जय सियाराम,
भज मन प्यारे जय सियाराम,
जय सियाराम, जय जय सियाराम,
जय सिया राम,
जय जय सिया राम,
जय सिया राम, जय जय सिया राम,
जय सिया राम, जय जय सिया राम,
जय सिया राम, जय
the world's tallest tower? Well, this place also houses the world's deepest swimming pool, the longest cantilever, the largest international gold market, and now also the world's highest spinning wheel. Dubai is a dynamic city known for its spectacular architecture and luxurious lifestyle that never fails to astonish both residents and tourists. Dubai's transformation from a fishing village to a global real estate cum financial hub has been nothing short of remarkable. From having the world's tallest buildings to islands in the shape of the world map, the UAE's most populous city has never shied away from ambitious construction projects.
Dubai's ruler, Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid Al Maktoum, summed up the ambition of his people in a quote, "Dubai will never stand for anything less than the first place." Indeed, the city's economic growth has been nearly unparalleled over the past two decades. Unlike neighboring Emirates, Dubai had a modest supply of oil and knew that diversifying their economy would be vital for future growth. Today, oil accounts on a minuscule 1% of Dubai's GDP. As the Middle East begins looking toward the post-oil economy, Dubai's success provides an example for other cities in the region to mimic.
Just as Dubai was hitting its stride, the global financial crisis blew in and choked the pipeline of money flowing into the growing city. In 2009, headlines around the world proclaimed that Dubai's real estate bubble had finally burst. Though the financial crisis was a setback, the city was quick to recover. And now, Expo 2020 is adding fuel to the twin engines of Dubai's economy, real estate development and tourism. With the UAE set to further relax foreign ownership rules, the city's economic prospects remain as sunny as its weather forecast.
According to His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid Al Maktoum, the Vice President and Prime Minister of UAE, and the ruler of Dubai, smart technology is a catalyst for happiness. Through widespread technological adoptions of technologies such as blockchain, virtual reality, commercial 3D printing, AI, robotics, hyperloop technology, etc., Dubai government is aiming to make the lives of its residents more convenient and less stressful. Imagine a video chat with virtually no latency, or imagine watching a 4K 360 degree video of migratory birds nesting in Galapagos Islands while you are in your Dubai apartment with a virtual reality headset. With 5G technology, surgeons sitting in America can conduct a high-risk surgery all the way in sub-Saharan Africa.
Behind all this, of course, is Sheikh Mohammed, the legendary political visionary without borders. He says this is only one slice of his master plan. He promotes growth, but not at all cost. Conscious that business is to be balanced with social responsibilities, that respect his people's culture and traditions, that deliver him a vibrant civil society and not a robotic nation. He says, our business story is about courage. It must also be about empowering people. I give people the confidence to complete a project, but they can't succeed if I'm standing right on top of them. Leadership is giving people the courage to succeed themselves.
Bold decisions and clever ideas that materialize fast has made Dubai one of the most visited places and an international hub. It involves people in service and trade and not just focus on oil-related transactions. These are people who travel to all around the world and negotiate, compete and win various different trophies in various different countries and in various different fields, from innovation to environmental practices.
This is conducive to the development of an independent entrepreneurial culture, which in return creates the perfect climate for the business to prosper. It also attracts industrial investments, which diversify the economy beyond oil, create jobs, and boosts economic growth. This is not just a reality in the engine, but a trend that affects other countries and their economies all around the world.
As an important hub in the Middle East and as an important station in the maritime Silk Route, Dubai has Belt and Road strategic prospects. Dubai wants to tackle the challenges of today and anticipate those of tomorrow by analyzing existing and emerging technologies such as 3D printing, virtual reality, autonomous vehicles, etc. Dubai found out a blue ocean opportunity, creating and shaping irreversible technological trends and matching them with current or future socio-economic challenges. Now let us see the reflection of Dubai's blue ocean strategy implementation. One of them is tourism. A 90-minute drive from Dubai through some breathtaking scenery, the Hatta Dam truly gives you a wonderful view of the blue-green water and the scenery beyond. It's a haven for water lovers with an option to rent a kayak, a water bike or an electric water boat to explore the lake and its surroundings with several other activities. There is an abundance of food trucks as it is a popular tourist spot and is one of those places where you get to walk among lush greenery in Dubai by taking a stroll on the footpath between farms. While it's a great day for a family, there's a lot of climbing involved, so small children will need care. But as a spot that reveals a totally different side of Dubai, it is a must-see on any visit.
A traditional palatial residence, Palace Downtown, is one of the best places to stay in Dubai. A sumptuous hotel that looks out over the wonderful Dubai fountain and the lake with Burj Khalifa at its center. Of heaven for those seeking some of the best leisure facilities in Dubai. Whether It is the palm-lined outdoor pool, or the traditional Arabian-style spa, or the fully featured gym with on-hand personal trainers. There is something for everyone. And that's not the only contender. Well, have Burj Al Arab, Atlantis the Palm, and El Maha, just to name a few.
Easily one of the most picturesque spots in Dubai, the Burj Dubai Abra Dock allows you to look out over to the traditional Arabic ports, known as dhows, to the modern cityscape beyond the water. This blend of the traditional and modern is always something special. But of course, you come to the dock not just to look, but to take a trip in one of these wonderful Arabic ports. The 10-minute trip from the dock to Golden Souk will take you along many of Dubai's landmarks, including the textile souk and the notable art galleries. This is a great way to slow down the place a little on your trip. Sit back and relax as the world rolls past.
Now, we could elongate the assembly to the extent that we could even write a PhD thesis on it. But one universal lesson that we all can learn from Dubai is success is hard. It embarks us on a voyage that is completely unprecedented with its own ups and downs. And the only fuel that keeps us running is courage and motivation, as aptly exemplified by the Dubai ruler, Mohammed bin Rashid Al Maktoum.
Tiranga meri jaan mein hai, tiranga mere imaan mein hai. Tiranga har ek mere armaan mein hai. Tirange mein utni hi shraddha hai, jitni mere bhagwan mein hai. Now let's arise for the national anthem. Assembly Saudan.
Janagana mana adhinayak jaya hind Bharat bhagya vidhata Punjab Sindh Gujarat Maratha Dravida Utkal Vanga Vindhya Himachal Yamuna Ganga Uchchal Jaladhi Taranga Tava Shubha Naame Jaage तव शुभ आशीष मांगे गाहे तव जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे
Ram. You know, sometimes life doesn't give us what we want. That doesn't mean that we don't deserve that thing. It only means that we deserve much more than that. Let's invite Shivram sir for today's point to socho.
Udyame nahi siddhyanti karyani na manorathe nahi suptasya simhasya pravishanti mukhe mruga. Namaste. Welcome back after a long slumber, long vacation of Diwali. Now this gives us time to review our past term and plan our next term. The Subhashit I mentioned talks about the efforts, talks about the importance of efforts. However mighty a lion may be, but the prey doesn't come to it. The lion goes to the prey. Lion goes to hunt. The prey doesn't come to it effortlessly. Similarly, for anybody who wishes to achieve anything significant in life has to strive for it. And there's no fun, there's no enjoyment in life without striving for something big, without aiming, without going for it. So, we're talking about Dubai today. And Dubai is nothing but an embodiment of somebody's figment of imagination. Dr. Bindra says people plan for a birthday party and Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid Al Maktoum plans for 10 years. There's a book by Grant Cardone, 10x Rule. If you haven't read it, please read it. It talks about the power of 10 times of imagination.
If you want to achieve something, let's say X amount, you should imagine it to be 10X and go for that 10X thing, because they say if you aim at the moon, you land up on the stars. Similarly, in our lives, what will we want to achieve in the next 6 months, 5 years, 10 years? Well, if it's so difficult to imagine 6 months, 1 year, 10 years, let's start from one day. If one day is difficult, 1 hour. Because if we can set or sort one day for ourselves, likewise, 1 week will be taken care of, 1 month will be taken care of, and ultimately, eventually, the entire life will be taken care of. So let's start by planning 1 hour at a day, 1 hour at a time. And do not forget to go through videos of Dubai. How did Dubai transform itself in a span of not more than 50 to 60 years? And this is historic. The tallest tower, the tallest building, the tallest hotel, world's largest buildings, hospitals, hotels, you name it and they have it. Either it's world's first or world's one and only. That's Dubai. But what makes Dubai, Dubai? It's just this. It's planning, 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 imagining. I'll end on a thought. If you can conceive it, believe it, you can achieve it. Think over it. Thank you.
Thank you, Shivaram sir, for sharing these wonderful points with us. I thank our music team, our technical team, all performers, last but not the least, our beautiful audience. Now, I invite music team to end this assembly with a beautiful exit song. Thank you.
Thank you.